Another hearing on the drug case of the son of Justice Secretary Crispin Remulla is being held at De Las Piñas Court. Our very own Jeff Caparaz now joins us with the latest from there. Jeff, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, the lawyers of Juanito Remulla III confirmed to us that they are awaiting for the resolution from the Pasay City Prosecutor's Office. When we had the chance to talk to Attorney Kit Belmonte, when he arrived here at the Las Piñas RTC Branch 197 earlier, that resolution will say if there's a probable cause to file illegal importation charge in court. Last November 9, Remulla's camp didn't file for a counter affidavit on drug importation charge in Pasay City Prosecutor's Office. So technically, they are waiting for the resolution since. We tried to interview Remulla's lawyers, but they still cite the sub judice rule. They only confirmed that Remulla, like the past other hearings here in Las Piñas RTC, will attend via video conference. This is the fifth hearing for the violation of the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act or the drug possession case of the younger Remulla here in Las Piñas. Remulla was nabbed during a controlled delivery operation by PIDEA and NAIA Interagency Drug Interdiction Task Group in Barangay Talon 2, Las Piñas on October 11. He pleaded not guilty to the drug possession charges on November 4 before Judge Ricardo Moldes II. Last November 10, Carmina, two chemists were present and a PIDEA representative that carries a box containing kush or high-grade marijuana was here. Earlier, we've seen three intelligence officers from PIDEA and a customs operation officer from the Bureau of Customs. And a while ago, a representative from PIDEA also arrived carrying a box and she said it also has evidences inside, including the kush. The next hearing is set tomorrow, November 29, for the prosecution. And the witness presentation from the defense is set on December 7, 14, and 22. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Jeff Caparaz there joining us this noon. On rates at the Cavitex C5 link just got higher. Jackie Minabat now joins us with the details. Jackie, over to you.
Carmina, motorists are welcome with a higher toll at Cavitex C5 link after Toll Regulatory Board approved the provisional toll adjustment effective yesterday, November 27. For Class 1 vehicles, motorists are charged 35 pesos. Class 2 vehicles are charged 69 pesos, while it's for 104 pesos for Class 3 vehicles. The additional toll is for the recently opened extension of the Cavitex C5 link, which extended the expressway at 1.6 kilometers from Merville to Airport View in Parañaque. The extended flyover opened in August 14. The toll operator was supposed to start charging the motorists in September. However, the regulatory board deemed it necessary to review the rates again because of the change in the administration. The implemented rates are 2 to 8 pesos lower than the initial approved rate. Toll regulatory board also said that rates are only provisional. So those who would still want to question the approved rates may file an appeal to review the toll. Next year, or 2023, the whole Cavitex C5 link project, spanning a total of 7.7 kilometers, will be opened. Travel time from Cavitex to Makati, Taguig, Pasay, or vice versa is expected to be reduced to 45 minutes only. The project is designed to decongest major thoroughfares such as EDSA and MIA Road. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Jackie Manabat, there joining us on the line. Take care, Jackie, and keep safe.